Many students want to do their PhD after they complete their master's or their honors degree. But what is a PhD and what does it entail? Let me share my views and explain to you what a PhD really is. But before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Vidhi Poddar. I'm an associate professor and you're watching a series of talks aimed at understanding the PhD process. So if you're ready to begin, let's go. First of all, PhD is a highest qualification that you can receive from a university. You start with your undergraduate degree, your postgrad or master's, and then the final qualification that you can get is a PhD. PhD is also a training program. It is a structured training exercise using which you acquire a new skill. What is that skill? The skill that you acquire in a PhD is to identify a problem and come up with a strategy to creatively solve it. So that is the key skill that you acquire as part of your PhD. PhD is not just about writing a thesis in the end. It is the core of new innovation and knowledge creation. I also think PhD is a process. It is a process of identifying problem, then figuring out different ways in which this problem could be solved, that is identifying different solutions, then using your creative abilities, figure out which of these solutions would be the ideal solution to solve this problem. So there is a selection process that is involved. So there is a problem, and then there are multiple solutions that you can think of, and you select one solution. So that creativity and that intellectual ability is very critical in this process. Once you select a solution, the next thing is you build it, implement it, depending upon what the solution is, and you come up with, you capture your findings, you collect your findings and report these findings to show that you have solved the problem and your solution to the problem is much better than what is already out there. PhD is also a knowledge creation platform. PhD gives you the opportunity to create some new innovations, technologies, solutions, techniques that can be beneficial to the society that we live in. It gives you the opportunity to make new discoveries, new inventions, thereby making the world a better place. Finally, after completing your PhD, you can call yourself a doctor. I hope this talk was interesting and useful for you if you're thinking of considering starting a PhD. If you have any questions, please feel free to write, leave them in the comments, and I'll try my best to answer all of those. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.